I don't want to be a victim. I want to be a victor in my own mind. Victims lay down to that, and victors say, I will overcome. And if I could do anything for other people is to help them to see my life as an example of where you can overcome.
Mellody Hobson is co-CEO and president of Ariel Investments, the Chicago-based money management firm where she climbed the ranks from intern over her 28-year career. She also sits on the boards of JP Morgan, Starbucks, Estee Lauder, and the video content company Quibi. I recently sat down with Mellody to discuss the fuel behind her barrier-breaking rise and how she's found the courage to be a true agent of change.
What does money mean to you? What does it represent to you?
Money boils down to something super simple for me, and that's security. When I think of money, I think of something very basic like housing and food and shelter. I think of being able to get to school or work. These were things that were really challenging for me as a child. My mother was a single mom, and she really struggled to make ends meet. And because of that, we had a real up and down financial existence that sometimes was we were fine, other times we were evicted. A lot often went wrong. And that really stuck with me. And it really cemented in me a desire to understand money, not to make it, to understand it. I wanted to know how it worked, and I wanted to know so that I would have enough and would ever be able to make good financial decisions. And that led me to my career in the investment business and this drive that I have to teach financial literacy to others.
If you think about your career in terms of decades, you started at your firm as an intern right out of college. How would you describe that early decade of your career and what allowed you to really be able to establish the track record that set the foundation for where you are now?
Well, it was great advice that I got from my mother when I first started working, and she said, make yourself indispensable. Make it so they cannot live without you. And they would never ever fire you. And I thought that was really great advice, and indispensable is just that. I was willing to do whatever it took, any time of the day, day or night, any project, it did not matter.
You also talked about the fact that sort of you pay then in your career that can afford you potential freedoms or liberties to own your time in a different way later on.
Yes, and this was a line that I heard Jesse Jackson once say, freedom is never free. You're gonna pay for it. And so for me, I was like, let me pay early and often so that later I have control. And that's exactly how it worked out. In the beginning, it's not your time, it's someone else's time. I worked around John Rogers, full stop. Like the sun rose and set on his calendar and his day because that was my responsibility. And over time, as I rose up in the organization and I had people reporting me and things like that, I could set the agenda and the schedule. Now I still work a crazy schedule, but it really did afford me the opportunity to have more control.
What have you learned about being a better or more impactful change agent throughout the course of your career?
Take the risk. Simple as that. I think a lot of people, because of fear, they don't act and they don't speak their truth. And I think it's really important. Your truth may not be the truth, but you should speak what is on your mind. Wise husband, you know, I'm married to Yoda's dad, who said, you know, Mellody, here's the one thing about life, it goes on. Tomorrow you wake up, you get dressed. He's like, people have tremendous tragedies and pain and anguish, and life goes on. And so when I'm in those moments of even feeling my own sense of shakiness or fear, maybe that courage not being served right up, I'll always ask myself, what is the worst thing that could happen to me? And so I just say to people, take the risk.
How do you define success at this point in your life?
Success is contentment to me. And that contentment comes in all sorts of forms. I see it in my six-year-old's face. That gives me a tremendous amount of contentment. And I say success when I see that face. Success is having a life partner that I cherish so much. Success is being able to work with people who are not just people, they're family to me. John Rogers is Everest's godfather. And success is really looking back at any day, any week, any month, and saying, what did I get done? And feeling good about it, be it for our clients at Ariel, be it for the boards that I'm on, be it for society, my teammates, what did I get done? I think about that all the time because we got one shot at this life, and to not be productive with what we have been given to me is a travesty. All of these stars aligned to give me this enormous opportunity. It's a miracle. what am I doing with this miracle?